Yeah, hi. Is this the Brick Academy officer? Hi, how you doing? How you doing? Cool. Yeah, I'm cool actually. Yeah, cool. Can you also fix the private jets that you sent me to Siberia with? Thank you, because it's a bit shaky. Thank you very much. That's cool. Okay, reason why I'm calling. I've been put under pressure about the whole Lukaku situation. He's currently suspended, but I'm under pressure for him to be expelled. So yeah, so we were looking to get him expelled because I believe he scored 3 goals in 2 games, scoring 2 crucial goals in a game against Southampton, both with his weaker foot, his right foot. So is this enough for him to be expelled from the Brick Academy? Because he's been in and out of the Brick Academy for the last year or so. So is this enough for him to get expelled? Okay. I'll tell them. Okay. All right. Okay. That's cool. All right, cool. Yeah. Okay, yeah, cool. All right. Yes, I'll be in Siberia next week. Okay, bye. They said no. He remains suspended. They said that he still needs to do a lot more in order for him to fully leave and be expelled from the Brick Academy. So I tried, I did what I could, but I couldn't. But this is about Lukaku. This is about Lukaku. But before we even get there, some of the goals in this game were outstanding. Some of the goals in this game were outstanding. Southampton's first goal was outstanding. Someone needs to do a name check. Who's that guy? Pereira's goal was flipping outstanding. The Ward-Prowse free kick was outstanding. And I think, look, before I get to United and everything, Hasenhüttl, Mark Hughes must never ever be allowed to come anywhere near a football side. How this dude has transformed this team from the garbage they were under Mark Hughes is incredible. Because Southampton, away from home, they played really well. As in, they had a very good shape. They were very solid. Guys halted very well. Romelu played really well. Redmond played really well. And they made it very difficult for United. United did not have it easy. They did not have it easy in this game. And that was not because of what they did, but because of how well Southampton were set up structurally, both defensively and attacking-wise. And Southampton, they created a lot of opportunities. So Hasenhüttl can't ask for anything more. He cannot ask for anything more from his boys in that game. I think for United, I think Pogba could have done more. Labille didn't show up in this game. Labille never turned up in this game. I think key thing here, because they're all coming up to me, Sanchez is done. He's finished. He's done. I believe that he's never leaving the Brick Academy from now until he retires from football. So even if he retires from football, there's a strong argument for him to be made an alumni. He's never leaving the Brick Academy. He is finished as a football player. As soon as he came off and when Dalot came on, United were transformed. They were transformed. So, because I was trying to explain this to people, I was explaining this to Terry, the United fan on UFF, and I said, bro, don't hold out hope on Sanchez. Trust me. I know this stuff. It's not me being arrogant or me being big-headed. I can see things, okay? And trust me when I say this. Sanchez is done as a viable entity. Sanchez is done as being an effective player at a top club. I don't know whether it's psychological, it's mental, it's an injury, something physical. He's completely done. It's over. United are badly missing Martial. 100%. Yeah, Rashford was on a very good goal scoring form, but I think he's dried up now. And the thing is that when Rashford dries up, he's a talented dude. He's a talented dude. He's not a Martial. And I think that they're missing both Martial and Lingard because, first of all, in Martial, they're missing just someone with a bit of technical ability in those attacking areas. Someone with a bit of craftiness and a bit of ideas to really make things happen up in that area. That's what they're missing key. So it is what it is over there, man. And Lingard is a key man who breaks from attacking midfield and can really add something to. Basically, he's the guy that breaks in from midfield, and that role that he plays in the number 10 role in that space is very crucial. Lukaku, 2 quality goals on his weaker foot. Because the first goal he scored, sorry, English white commentators, I see no pace and power. That's a quality goal. Great feints, great dribble. Quality finish with his right foot. Again, I'm sorry, wise commentators. There's no pace, there's no power, there's no strength there. That's just complete, total, amazing technical quality finish. And for his winner, he had to take off his shirt. Right foot again from that angle. Maybe your boy Don could have done well, but from that angle, it's amazing. So I'm happy for Lukaku. As much as I want him to be in the Brick Academy, as much as I want Bricks to stay there, the other side of me wants Bricks to improve. The whole point of the Academy is to improve you, is to name and shame you, and for you to look inside of yourself and to improve thyself. So for Lukaku, huge, amazing, because this could be three crucial points, because now I believe the gap between them and Tottenham might be 2 points or 3 points, I'm not sure. So it's a crazy, it's a crucial, crucial, big, big, huge win for United. And for Solskjaer, man, he's the dude. You have to give him the full-time job. He really deserves the job because he has lifted the spirits of this damn team. So for Lukaku, you're still suspended. Will he get expelled by the time we finish the season? I do not know. But all I say is this, that for a guy to do that on his weaker foot, under the kind of pressure that he's on, bro, I flippin' salute you. Thanks for watching the video. Now think about becoming a Football Hot patron by pledging an amount each month and then gain access to exclusive content only on the Football Hot Patreon page. Peace. Head over to the official site at halffootballhot.com or just click over here.